Hello there, a very good morning. Christopher Ecclestone is joining us today to discuss once again Panther Metals. I know this is a company you follow and analyse quite regularly, and your report that we just published, Christopher, is this sharpening the focus on Ontario.
Yes. Yep. Panther have done it again. For a company that's constantly on the move or on the prowl, Panther have now disposed of one of their major assets in Ontario. And in the process, they've spun it out into a soon-to-be-listed on the AIM entity called Fulcrum Metals. And in exchange for the passing of the Big Bear project to Fulcrum, they will receive 20% of Fulcrum's IPO equity. They will also have in perpetuity a 2% NSR on the production if Fulcrum get it to production. So, they're double winners there. Then they turned around and to sort of wash and repeat, so to speak, as they do, they picked up something called the Shear Gold Project, which is also in Ontario. And so effectively what Panther do is they monetize assets. So firstly, they had a portfolio that consisted of assets in Canada and assets in Australia. Then last year, they spun out the assets in Australia into an entity on the ASX, which they have, if I remember correctly, something like 36% of. So now they've got 36% of Panther Metals Australia, which is listed. They'll soon have 20% of Fulcrum Metals listed on the AIM. Then they've got their portfolio of Canadian assets. So the Shear Gold asset is an interesting one, which you can read about in the report, because it's in some highly prospective territory there. And so they will be then focused once again on Ontario, which they have been since the Australian deal. But wait for the next deal. They seem to be serial deal doers. And the goal there is to build an asset base, which is projects that they work on, then spin them out and increase the net asset value of Panther Metals PLC in the process.
And just in simple terms, what is the advantage of having this structure set up?
Well, when you've got an exploration project, essentially has only the value that you acquired it for. And in some cases, if you're staking a project, that could be a few hundred Canadian dollars. Then you invest money into it. In this case, with Panther, we can identify out of its market cap that they own 36% of the market cap of the thing in Australia. They own 20%, they will own 20% of Fulcrum. So you've got an underpinning for the market cap of Panther that is over and beyond the somewhat nebulous value of exploration projects, which until you either sell them or develop them or give them up, is anybody's guess. They're underpinning their market cap, really. And that's a good thing because people then know that, it has some intrinsic value rather than just, we're doing this drilling, the drilling results are good, put your own value on it. In this case, we can put a concrete value upon those two holdings. And I would suspect, knowing the management and seeing what they've done in the past, that we'll be seeing more deals, more value accretion through these spin-outs, et cetera, et cetera. And I don't view them as a classic sort of project generator model because they're sort of building a corporate grouping here, which is interesting.
Yeah, really interesting. Christopher, thank you very much indeed for explaining all of that. And if you do want more detail, you can get to the report, access it by the eye in the corner of the screen by Christopher Ecclestone, one of our proactive research analysts here, talking about Panther Metals, sharpening the focus on Ontario. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.